Song! Let's go! Body, itty, arms in action. Action, in action, in action, in action, in action. Let's get this started with, let's start with a bag of nerds. This is a bag of nerds, and here's how we do it. Now, a bag of nerds, that basically means you go ahead and, well, you're really nervous, you're anxious, and you're not really confident that you will be able to do things. That's what a bag of nerves means. And it basically means you're in a nervous or very anxious state. And so, for example, here, ever since I was young, when I performed, I always gave me a bag of nerves. Well, we signed to say that to fix your fears, you have to confront them. Do you feel better? No, now I'm scared of scientists as well. What? Yes, that is true. Next word is a bone of contention. A bone of contention basically means an argument or disagreement between people. Like, neither side's gonna budge. And, like, yeah. And who proved to be such a bone of contention? Like, going. Who's not choosing where to go for the weekend would be a bone of contention? We wanna go. I wanna go to the Becker match. I wanna go to the mountains. I wanna go to the sea. Well, since no one can decide where they want to go, I will do what I want. Shopping. Now, where will we go in our next holiday? I hate you. Those kinds of things. Yeah. Our next is a foot in both camps. Now, a foot in both camps basically means you are in two parties and you maintain links with both parties of size. And typically, you, in order to promote your own interests, like, yeah. I'm hoping that, like, here we go. I'm hoping Danny will just go ahead and ask me for the school dance. I've heard you already asked someone else. Oh, well, it's a good thing I already asked out. I already told Tom I'd go with him. It's good to have a boot in both parties. Good to have a foot to keep a foot in both parties. It's nice. They're both happy. Yeah. That's pretty good. Next word is a lump in your throat. Now, this basically means you're feeling sad and you feel like you're about to become emotional and start crying about something. Like, I always get a lump in my throat whenever I watch these emotional dramas. Well, yeah, well, you women are so weak. You guys will we men are very strong. You must have a stone mirror. You have a heart of stone if you don't cry at this. Boo-hoo! Yeah, this is pretty good. Yeah, this is awesome. At least he cries a bit too much. Our fifth word, idiom, is a pain in the neck. Now, a pain in the neck basically means you're doing something that really irritates you, or something or someone that irritates you and causes an inconvenience. Now, here you go. Sorry to be a pain in the neck, but can I borrow a lawnmower? Mine just broke. You borrowed one last week and you still haven't returned it. Oh, then this must be the one yours must be the one I broke. Do you have another one that I can borrow? No, 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 no. I'm locking the shed until you pay me it back. Yeah, do not borrow from someone else unless you're really sure you're going to keep it safe. Our sixth idiom is a safe pair of hands. Basically means you're in a safe position and you won't mess up anything. You have a safe pair of hands you are relied on to do something about risky, but risking it or going wrong, terribly wrong. Seventh is a slip of the tongue. A slip of the tongue basically means you're like, when you accidentally say something, that accidentally reveals something you had not intended them to know. Like, you know, it's just a slip of the tongue when I said I did not like birthday cakes. A birthday cake, birthday party without a birthday cake is not a party at all. I mean, yeah, don't go get a cake though. Oh, I really wish they didn't take it literally. Our eighth is a toe in the water. Basically means you just dipped it in and you're all like, hey, you took your first step towards achieving a big goal. Like, if you make good progress, you have a toehold in it. Yeah. There. Like, here we go. There. I think the window's done. Look at how clean we made it. Well, that's not it. Look at how much more we have to clean. Oh, well, we put a toe in the water. Knife is an eye for an eye. Based on the biblical references, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth,
And now you got on my line, I will go to yours by killing you! Ah!
Yeah, that's crazy, man. So you give an exchange or do a punishment towards someone where that someone did the same thing to you. Like if they took your chicken nugget, you would take their chicken nugget. If they took your chips, you would take their chips. If they took your Xbox, you take their PS5 or something like that. Unless they have an Xbox. So yeah. Hey, you've been taking my chips. Well, yours look nicer. Hey, look there.
Oi.
As they say, an eye for an eye. And our last one is armed to the teeth. Armed to the teeth. Armed to the teeth. That basically means they're equipped with a bunch of weapons. Numerous weapons. Like this. Hey, I'm armed to the teeth. Big, I'm armed to the teeth. Come away, stranger. But I'm a dragon. Pew, 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 pew. I have a sword. Oh, no. There we go. And this is it. I thought I heard something down there. There seems to be something in the teeth. Shh. They might be armed to the teeth. Meow. It's just the cats drinking milk. Yeah. And that's it. Yeah, there we go. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and I hope to see you guys soon. And until the next time, Shnan out. Peace! Da-dun-dun, da-dun-dun, da-dun-dun.